everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're here, you're here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to see me open and unbox the VT Cosmetics x BTS collaboration cosmetics line. I was lucky enough to receive a box of products from VT Cosmetics, and I shared a bit of it on my Instagram story, and a lot of you seemed interested in an unboxing video, like a first impressions video, a full face makeup video. So for this one, I'm just going to do the unboxing and open the products for the first time. And then in the future, I'll probably do a full face makeup video after I've gotten to use the products a little bit more and just are more familiar with how best to use them so I can, you know, best advise you guys. I'm pretty excited for this unboxing because it combines two of my favorite things, which is music or just BTS and makeup. So I'm very, very excited. I definitely do not have all of the products, just a few things from their collection. This is the box that they sent me. I'm just gonna be pulling things out of this box, and I really wanted to do this unboxing because I just wanted a casual video where I could just sit down and talk with you guys, because I feel like I haven't really done that in a while, and I know like vlogs kind of give you guys a glimpse into my life and what I'm doing every day or every other day or monthly. It's just nice to like sit down and chat with you guys, especially about something that I love, and if you're here, something that you love too. First, I did get a poster. I'm trying so hard not to fangirl right now. But yes, I got this poster. Yeah, I just wasn't even expecting that. I have no words, I have no words. But they all look really good, so. I'm totally like, I feel like I'm revealing myself as like a true like BTS fan now. Like, I know I talk about it and sprinkle it in here and there, but this video will tell all. Next, they also gave me some of the photo cards, which are just so amazing. So let's open this one first so I can show you guys. That's Jimin. Jimin, my Korean's really not that great, you guys. And that's J-Hope, Jungkook, JK. I need to cover my face because it won't focus on. There you go, that's Jin. There's V, RM, and then this is Suga. And then the second photo card. So this one's Jimin again. Is this J-Hope? I can't see. This is J-Hope. So pretty. Jungkook. I would say they're Korean names, but I'm really bad at Korean pronunciations, especially for J-Hope. Hoseok. This is Jin. Suga. This is RM. And then V. Oh yeah, and then on the back they do sign it also. So that's really cute. I didn't even look at that. So I haven't read really anything about the products. I haven't read reviews or really, I don't really know the backstory behind it. I just Googled it really quickly. So the line has three parts to it. The first part is a skincare line, and I think it's called Natural. The second part is called Gloria or Glorious, which is their like base makeup. And then the third one is called Tempting, which is like their color makeup. And I don't really know the difference because the base makeup has a bunch of lip colors. The color one has a bunch of eyeshadows. So I'm not really sure how it's classified really. I will show you what I got in the mail from them. And I'll try to go in categories, like I'll do face products first, eyes, and then lips. So first, this is their Super Tempting Face Fixer. Setting fixer forms a thin fixing layer to offer radiance and shining of the skin and sets the makeup perfect during the whole day. So I think this is a primer. Wow, pretty. It's a really nice purple. Oh, it's a spray. Nice and misty. Feels very nice and light. Oh, I'm so stupid. It's a setting spray. Obviously, it says sets the makeup perfect during the whole day. So I'm just gonna spray myself a little bit then. Oh, okay, I smell it more now. It's kind of like a very rosy floral scent. I like it, like it reminds me of home and a little bit of potpourri actually, but like it's a really nice faint potpourri smell and not like the overwhelming kind. This is the primer and this is from the Glorious Gloria line. Illuminate the skin with boosted radiance, smooth skin texture, provide synergic effect in makeup. Oh, cute. It's like a little dropper. I love that. Whoa, it's very milky and creamy. That's so interesting. It's milky. Oh, nothing's coming out. Okay. Whoa, but when I look at it through the bottle, it comes out purple. If this is gonna give me skin like BTS, I'm here for it. Like, it looks really iridescent, but I can't. Okay, there you go. This is what my hand looks like without the product on. Oh, I'm kind of sad about the dropper. It just doesn't dispense very well. Like, do you see that? Wow. Okay, I'm really excited to use that. That's really pretty. Do you guys see the difference? Like there's such a glow and a shine on this hand and not so much on this one. Pretty. I really wish the dropper worked a bit better though. Ugh. Yeah, the dropper doesn't dispense very well, but that's okay. I don't care. Do we really care? Now we have the Powerdation and I'm assuming this is their foundation. They gave me two of these and you know, I really hope that one of these works for my color. I do use the VT Cosmetics cushion and I love that cushion, but they are so limited in colors and I wish they would make more. I don't know what their plans are to do that. Hopefully they will expand and create more of a range. It's really, really unfortunate. It makes me really sad because their product is amazing. From what I've learned from other brands is that it's really difficult to get the darker color range while still maintaining the integrity of the formula and the ingredients. So it just takes a little bit longer to develop that. That was something I learned from an American brand actually, and also from a Korean beauty brand. Hopefully they're working on it because I would love for more people to be able to try their cushions. Even for me, some of their cushions are too light. Cute. So this comes in a dropper also. This is their foundation and they gave this to me in two shades, 3 and 4, which is beige and sand respectively. So let's just open both of them. So let's try 3 first. I learned recently from watching Chloe Morello that when you match your foundation, you should match it to your body, like to your arms or like your neck rather than your face, because overall your face is just lighter than your body in general. That's true for me. So now I'm kind of like, why haven't we been doing that all along? That's just, you know, a pro tip for you guys to start matching your foundation to your body so that it's like the same color all over. Even now, I feel like my face is lighter than my body, even though my cushion that I use, which is the VT Cosmetics cushion, matched my face today. This is also a dropper. This one seems to work a little bit better. Do I just not know how to use a dropper? Yeah, this one works a little bit better. I'm pretty sure this color is too light for me. And this is in the 3 color. Beige, I think. Yeah, that's way too light. Wow, it's really thick. Very creamy. Oh my. It's very light. It's neutral. It's a neutral smell. This is a very matte formula. This is in the color 4. Okay, this looks a little bit closer to my color. Let's apply that on this hand. I'm just gonna do a little bit. Okay. This also looks a bit light. I really wanted it to match so that I could use it. Maybe if I blended it in more, it could be better. Actually, this doesn't look bad. In the viewfinder, it looks really light, but it matches pretty well. Very subtle difference. I think this is more peachy. And this is more yellow. Yeah, I think I'll try like that one. I feel like this matches pretty close. So I'll try that one when I do the full face makeup video. I don't even know if I have enough products to do a full face makeup video, but we'll see when I get through this. Next we have the eye palette. I opened this on Instagram. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, feel free to follow me there. I post on my feed like every other day and on my story pretty much every day. It's just a much more like real time thing. So I did share this on the Instagram. It's really pretty. Like I had no idea what kind of colors to expect when I opened it. I love the colors. It's like right up my alley. Let's just swatch all of these. Ooh, that's really pretty. I wish the camera would do a better job of focusing. Wow. Next I'll swatch this one. Is it focusing? Is it focusing? Ooh, that's also really pretty. Now I will do the brown one. Is it brown? It's like a brick red. Whoa. It's very soft. It's powdery. It's not like a velvet texture or anything like that. So now I'll swatch this one. Wow. I'm pretty impressed. Okay, let's swatch this pale, like yellowish color. Cream color. I'll do it on this hand. Yeah, wasn't expecting much. Now let's do the darkest color in the palette. It doesn't have a name on this, so I can't really say what it is. To use my thumb. Wow! I don't know if it's because my thumb has a bigger surface area, but that's a lot of color. Ooh. Hopefully I did a good job with the swatches. Do you guys see that? I feel like this pink one I didn't do very good. Let me try and do better swatches so that you guys can get a full, like a better view of all the colors. Can you guys see all the colors there? They all look really nice. I can't wait to play around with it. And I love that it's a very neutral color palette. Very wearable, very usable. It is warm tone. I don't know if they have a cool toned palette. I'll have to look later. I just need to wipe my fingertips. While I'm doing this, I thought I might as well share like how I first discovered BTS. I talked about this before, but for those of you who are new or like haven't heard, I actually first heard of BTS through Sydney and Karen. They were showing me their music videos one day and I was like, oh, that's cool. Like I thought they were super talented and just like really great dancers and singers. They showed me like a bunch of their music videos from Dope to Blood, Sweat, and Tears to Fire. And I was like, oh yeah, this is cool. Like I see like why you guys like it, I get the appeal. And then I actually stumbled on one of their older music videos for Just One Day, and that was the video where I fell in love with BTS. It's funny because like I don't hear a lot of people say that that's the one that, you know, converted them, gave them new life, but that's the one for me. Like after I heard that song and saw the video, I had it on repeat for so long. It's just like a really sweet song and I loved it. Like I love that like R&B kind of popish vibe. Don't get me wrong, like I really love Dope and Fire and Blood, Sweat, and Tears also, but the one that won me over totally was Just One Day because it was just such a sweet song. Like I love it. Every time I listen to it now, I still get really happy. And like before the Love Yourself series came out, a lot of my favorite songs from them were from the like the Best Moment in Life or something. Young Forever, the Young Forever series. I loved like Autumn Leaves and Tomorrow, House of Cards, all of those songs. And I also loved like Look Here, Where Are You From? Like I love all of those, like the more R&B type music. Okay, wow. So this is their Tempting Cheek palette. It's pink instead of purple. Really cute. Ooh. They're very vibrant actually. This is really bright. Let's swatch that one first. Yeah, it's a very like hot bubblegum pink type of color. Now I'm swatching the middle one. That one actually, like they apply really nicely. And it's also very, I did a really messy job now that I'm smudging it. But they blend out really, really well. Like, that looks very natural. Wow, that looks really pretty, actually. Okay, now I'm gonna do the light pink one. Sorry if I keep looking at the viewfinder instead of the camera, guys. It's literally my only mirror right now. Okay, that one is very... That one blends out really nicely, too. I'm really shocked. I feel like they almost blend out like a tint. It just blends out really nicely. I'm impressed. I actually do like that. At first I was like, oh, these don't look like very wearable colors, but they blend out really nicely and I can see myself wearing this one a lot because it's more of a corally, like everyday color. The very faint pink is maybe too light for me. And then this one is something I would wear for maybe a really bold blushed look. Oh, I realized I didn't read the boxes for any of the palettes so far. I wanna read it because I wanna know what VT Cosmetics' take is on all of these products. For the eye palette, that one was called Modern Neutral, number one. Shadow palette for sensual eye look with a variety of color schemes and soft feel. And then the cheek palette, I got number two in Forever Young. Cheek blush revitalizes your cheeks with its soft and silky texture that lightly adheres to the skin without caking. Yeah, that for sure. Didn't cake, like it was just so easy to blend out. This is their super tempting shade palette. Three color shading for sharpening the face line with a natural shading effect. Okay, so this is also in a pink color. Ooh, I really like these colors. This probably works a lot better for lighter medium skin tones over darker ones, but I will swatch these anyway. This is the darkest shade. This is the middle shade. It's pretty much the same texture as the blush, so I know this is gonna blend out pretty well. The light color, the middle one, pretty much just blended right into my skin, so it's not really visible. I'll probably have to contour and shade with the darkest one. The rest of the box has a lip balm and then a few lip colors, so let's start opening those. This is their Gloria Lip Color Balm. Soft texture with moisture. Change the color to match with your lips. Oh, that's cool. Vivid color and shining. This is in the color number three, Melrose. A moisturizing color lip balm around lips with soft watercolor. So I'm not gonna apply this on my lips because I have lip color on. That's the shade. That's interesting that this is supposed to adjust to your lips because there's a shade. I thought it was gonna be like a clear neutral color. It feels like it would wear pretty comfortably. It's really light and sheer, so I'm excited to try that out. When I first discovered BTS, Jungkook was definitely my bias. When I saw him in Dope, I was just like, he's cute. But as I got more into watching their vlogs, like their videos, their V lives, and their bombs, Bangtan bombs, I hope I'm saying that right. As I got more into that, V started becoming my bias because I loved his eccentric, like funny, out there personality. And then over time, I really just have learned to love them all. First of all, I love their music, and then I love that they're genuine people. I love that whole message of love yourself, and people always say you discover BTS when you need them the most, and I definitely needed them the most when I came out to LA and was trying to adjust and transition. It's crazy because I got this tattoo like 6 years ago, and the meaning behind this tattoo was to remind me to love myself and to love others. The message of their Love Yourself series just really resonates with me, and so I have very close ties with them. This is my K-pop phase. I didn't have a K-pop phase in high school. Like, I had heard of Wonder Girls and Big Bang, and I listened to like Taeyang in college, but it just wasn't like, it didn't hit with me. Back to the makeup. This is actually a gel eyeliner, not a lip color. This is their Super Tempting Skinny Gel Eyeliner in number three, Milk Brown. Gel pencil eyeliner makes super fine lines with 1.5 millimeters thick gel that is uniquely designed for drawing detailed and precise lines. And it is very, very thin. It's so thin, like it feels like it's gonna break. Yeah. I feel like I have to be really careful with this. I don't wanna break it. Ooh, this is a really pretty brown color. It's very soft and glides on so easily. I wish they gave me a black one. Oh, there's another eyeliner in here actually. This one is in rose brown. The one I just tried is in milk brown. So let's try rose brown. I'm definitely excited to give this a try and like to draw a winged line with pencil because it's really hard to draw a winged line with the pencil liners that I have now because they're so thick, but this one is so incredibly thin. I wonder how BTS uses this. Like what color would they use? Like how would they use this color? This rose brown one. Okay, so now we're moving on to the lip colors. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in here. This first one is in the color 10, Earth Us. Liquid lip rouge, specifically designed to fit lightly on the lips to provide intense and vivid lip colors. That's what it looks like. I can't believe they have their own cosmetics line with VT. That's really cool. Wow, this is like a really interesting color. So I'll swatch this here. Yeah, this is just like a clear, pale, clear color. Like it's a very light pink. There's some like iridescence to it. I don't even know if it'll show up on the camera. There's a very subtle sheen, like iridescence to it. This one is In the Mood. Ooh, this is a matte color. This is really pretty. It looks like a rosy color. Wow. Wow. Ooh, this is really pretty. This is like a velvet lip tint. I like that. It feels very soft and lightweight. It's not heavy at all. Ah, can't wait to try that one. I'm not gonna try on any of these lip colors because I just have such a dark lip on today. Okay, so this is in number 9, Urban Code. I'm wondering if you can tell the difference between what is a matte lip color and what isn't. You can't really tell, it doesn't say. Yeah, they all say they're lip rouges, and unless it says in Korean, it doesn't say whether or not it's a gloss or not. So this one is more like a corally color at first glance. Can you guys tell that there's a difference between this one and this one? Mmm, smells like candy. Is this what BTS smells like? The thoughts running through my head right now that I'm not gonna say out loud. I'm trying to keep this about the makeup mostly. You know, trying to be a professional. Trying to be. I don't know if I'm succeeding or not, but the effort's there. Okay, so this is number 3, NVU. Gloss or matte? Matte! It's not that I don't like glosses, it's just you can't really see the color difference. So that's why I'm like more excited for the matte ones right now, or the velvet ones. This looks like a very bright pink. Oh, it's like a fuchsia color, like a bubblegum. I don't usually wear colors like this, but it's BTS, so I'll give it a try. I feel like this is much more cool toned. I saw that BT Cosmetics is actually launching another BTS line with the BT21 characters, and they are so cute. I love the BT21 characters. I even play the BT21 Puzzle Star game. I was really obsessed with that game for a little bit. Oh, that line is so cute. Like, I wish I had something from there. I wish I had anything BT21 in. There is a line store that opened up on Hollywood and I haven't been able to go. And part of me doesn't wanna go because going to Hollywood is insane. So I haven't made it out there yet. Oh, I really like this one. This one reminds me of the 3CE one that I wear all the time. This one's a little bit more rosy though. But it looks really cute and really wearable for every day. Actually, this looks a bit more pink than the one I wear from 3CE, but it's still really cute and I feel like this is pretty good for every day. The one I have from 3CE is a bit more nude. This is a bit more pink. Last product. Oh, which one was that one called? Did I say? That one was in 1 called Moment, and this one is in 2 called Something. Ooh, this one is also a matte lip color. Looks very bright. Ooh, this is like a magenta color right there. Wow, that's very vivid. How pretty. So those are all the lip color swatches. Yes, that is it. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and unboxing the VT Cosmetics BTS collaboration products with me. I had a lot of fun doing this video because I got to talk about 2 things that I really, really love. Since I am doing a full face makeup tutorial, if there are any specific products you guys are curious about or want me to try or have questions about, let me know so that I can try and cover those questions in the makeup tutorial. Tell me, please tell me, what is your favorite BTS song and who is your bias, if you can even choose one, honestly. Tell me, please tell me. I would love to know and just fangirl together. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. It feels so nice to just sit down and like talk with you. Also, a huge, huge thank you to VT Cosmetics for sending me these products to try and test out and share with all of you. And I will see you in my next video. Bye! Also, if you haven't watched my Paris vlog yet, please go watch it. Yeah.